Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to be looking at performance in CMU 1.11.3 using the triple core recompiler and my i3-8350K clocked at 4.8 GHz. In this video, I am using FPS++ and a custom version of the 30fps lock pack that locks my FPS so it does not go over 144fps. As you can see on screen, we are getting absolutely crazy performance in areas where we previously were not seeing over 45fps. When I actually installed 1.11.3, I could literally not believe my eyes when I saw the performance levels. I am hitting well above 100fps in areas like Hyrule Field and certain shrines. Let's just swap across to Kakariko Village and see what performance is like in this area. If you watched my previous video I released earlier today, you saw that I did not go over 60fps due to the fact that I was capping out on my GPU usage. In this video, I am only using the 1440p plus high resolution Shadows graphics pack. I am not using Clarity or any other graphics packs as they are having some kind of weird issue with this new release of CMU. This is to be expected as these new compilers, both dual and triple core recompilers, are listed as being unstable and are disabled as default. This is only to be expected though as this is a brand new feature that we have never before seen in CMU emulator. Due to its experimental nature, we are going to have to wait maybe until the next release or the release after that for it to be perfected and it to be as stable as we can possibly expect. Let's switch over to some combat gameplay and see exactly what performance is like when we have large amounts of NPCs, enemy AI and complex geometry rendered into our game world. As previously stated, you can now see that I am rendering well above 100fps on this i3 CPU. Let's now drop down to where we have some enemy AI and see what performance is like there. As with my previous video showing off the dual core recompiler, we are not using GX2 Draw Done, the feature which allows for GPU and CPU synchronization. As stated in my dual core recompiler showcase video, this GX2 Draw Done option was giving me quite large and significant FPS drops up to 25%, reducing me from 60 to 70fps all the way down to 40, 45 and 50fps. Once again, this is due to the experimental nature of these new recompilers, however, we are still seeing absolutely fantastic performance. If we were to quantify exactly how much of a performance increase we are seeing, in my testing in this area, on CMU 1.11.2, the highest FPS we saw was 49, and the lowest FPS we saw was 34. If you compare and contrast those FPS highs and lows with the performance you have seen previously and are seeing on screen right now, then the performance delta between these two versions is absolutely astounding. In the coming days, I'm going to be doing some testing on my 2600K, my 3570K, and if they arrive in time, my FX 6100 and 8350. As always guys, cheers for checking out the video, remember to like it if you liked it, dislike it if you didn't, and subscribe to the channel if you want to see all future videos from me.